It's not every day we cover a famous outlaw on this... what? This is about a different Jesse James. And it's not about the famous football player who has been in recent news either. Nope. This video is about the Jesse James who appeared on Monster Garage and sells firearms. This is TUNANOCRUST, and today we're looking at the mastermind behind Monster Garage. Where did Jesse G. James come from, what's in his name, and where is this Jesse James today?
You had the perfect life. You had the perfect wife. Why did you throw it away?
I don't know, you know, during the midst of all of it and when I was doing it, I knew it was horrible. It made me feel horrible. And two, I knew I would get caught eventually, and I think I wanted to get caught. It was me trying to self-sabotage my life.
First, it might amuse you to know that Jesse G. James's name similarity might not be a coincidence. He claims to be related, albeit distantly, to the outlaw, Jesse James. There is no evidence to back his claim. He has declined to submit DNA samples for testing. Every move he has made in his life has nonetheless been doing that name justice, for better or for worse. Jesse Gregory James was born in Linwood, California on April 19, 1969. His parents divorced at a young age, leaving him to mostly be raised by his father, an antique dealer named Larry. Without getting too detailed, James suffered severe emotional and physical abuse as a child. This led him to claim that he never had a chance to be a kid. Motorcycles became the light of Jesse James's childhood. His dad's antique shop was next door to a Harley-Davidson shop. When he was around 6 years old, he was stunned by the noise and chrome of a pack of Hell's Angels passing by. That was when he knew that motorcycles would be a big part of his life. And even though his father Larry might not have been the best person, he knew talent when he saw it. He got Jesse James his first dirt bike when he was 7, and the kid loved it to pieces. We mean that literally. Not only did he ride his dirt bike everywhere, but he also liked taking anything apart to see if he could improve it. He was the same way with Legos and Tonka trucks. But his real aspiration was to join the NFL. Jesse G. James played football from high school into college. This dream did not last long.
What schools did you get scholarship offers from?
Every Division I school in the country. So,
wow.
You know, which at the time, outside linebackers wasn't a big plethora of them, and like, you know, Lawrence Taylor was, you know, that kind of size, you know, was awesome, like 6'3", 240, fast, and I was all of those.
After several football injuries, Jesse G. James began looking for other jobs. At 19, he dropped out of college and began serving as a bouncer and bodyguard for various bands, including Slayer, Glenn Danzig, and Soundgarden. So, what happened between his bodyguard life and Monster Garage? A lot. Let's break it all down. In 1993, James fell off the stage at a concert, dislocating his shoulder and taking him off bodyguard duty. He proceeded to open West Coast Choppers in his mother's garage. Some say the company technically started earlier in 1992. James was so fond of the biker lifestyle that he made t-shirts before he had bikes to sell. But someone with a name like Jesse James can never be far from controversy. From 1997 to 2006, West Coast Choppers made around 50 bikes that broke California state emissions laws. They have fixed emissions since. The chopper shop also moved from Long Beach, California to Austin, Texas. The garage was still successful enough that Discovery decided to make a movie about it. In 2000, Discovery Channel produced a documentary on James's already impressive life. It was called Motorcycle Mania and showed James's everyday goings-on. This one documentary threw James into the spotlight. He has since made motorcycles for Kid Rock, Keanu Reeves, and Shaquille O'Neal. After that, Discovery worked with Jesse James and other host Tom Beers to create a show about modifying vehicles. The show had rough rules, including a timetable for how long they had to build cars. Day 1 was for designing, days 2 to 6 were for developing, and day 7 was for testing. The announcer, Brett, the Big Schwag Wagner, added spice to the episodes by commenting on how crazy the changes were.
That is a Dillon minigun. Say hello to Shredder number 2.
But he is most famous for signing off episodes with, "The next Monster Garage challenge is just around the bend." Monster Garage is exactly what it sounds like. James turns regular cars into monsters. But it's more like he Frankensteins them into other vehicles entirely. Some of his more extreme metamorphoses include a Chevy Impala into a Zamboni machine, a school bus into a boat, and a limousine into a fire truck. As with many car shows, time is limited, making these transformations even more impressive. He wanted to make a monster that could go over 200 miles per hour. It did not happen. That said, not every car project was successful. There was roughly a 1 in 10 chance of a car being a failed monster. One of the first and most notorious of these failures was the Cadillac Hearse, which was supposed to become a car that could crush other vehicles. The attempt to put a backhoe on a hearse did not go well. Jesse James hates failure, but before the car was sent to the scrapper, the team put a propane tank on it. The original Grim Ripper went out in a blaze of glory. But the idea came back with a vengeance in season 2. Their second attempt at a hearse that could steal your soul was much more successful. It came complete with a morbid paint job and a backhoe painted like a gigantic skeletal head. Jesse James didn't particularly like working with hearses, but he made it work. During the run of Monster Garage, James had a turbulent, star-studded personal life. He had married once in 1991 and had 2 kids, Chandler and Jesse Jr. James divorced his wife in 2002 and married Janine Lindemulder, a star and producer of adult movies, shortly thereafter. They had a daughter named Sunny before James got another divorce in 2004. In 2005, Sandra Bullock, yes, that Sandra Bullock, showed her 10-year-old godson around the set of Monster Garage because he was a huge fan. The two got married in July of the same year. They adopted a child, Louis Bardo Bullock, from New Orleans shortly before everything fell apart. This red carpet marriage did not last. In 2010, numerous reports of James cheating on Bullock came to light. The reports included some big names, including tattoo artist Kat Von D and model Michelle McGee. Allegations of James being a white supremacist added salt to the wound. Bullock and James divorced on June 28, 2010, citing a conflict of personalities. But the problems were clearly present before the divorce. TMZ reported James checking into the Arizona rehab clinic Sierra Tucson on March 31, 2010, a good 3 months before the divorce became official. He claims he did it to repair his marriage. In his own words, James said, "I'm the guy that ruined my marriage because I banged some stripper. There's got to be some flaw in my personality that made me think that was okay." Whatever treatment they gave him did not last. He was out after a week and had more broken relationships following the divorce. Pause for a little bit and note the timeline. While the affairs we know about started roughly in conjunction with the show and are well documented, James had personal issues with or without stardom. Monster Garage ended in 2006, and the major reports of his affairs came in around 2010. However, his issues explain the massive gap between seasons 4 and 5. He also had cameos in other Discovery shows in the interim, including Sons of Guns and American Chopper. If your favorite Discovery show has motorcycles, you might see Jesse James. The original Monster Garage lasted 4 seasons, ending on June 12, 2006. It was supposed to come back to TLC in 2020, but was postponed due to world events. Instead, the last season of Monster Garage aired on Discovery Plus, the network's new streaming service, in January of 2021. In between the 4th and 5th seasons, Jesse James looked into another business venture, custom firearms.
I come from South Central LA, where it's like home invasion robberies and carjacking. So like, if you don't have a pump action shotgun in your house, you're dumb. You know, you're a dummy.
He unveiled his first 2 guns, a 1911 pistol and an AR-15 rifle. Since then, his shop has gone on to make custom guns that cost thousands of dollars. He claimed to make a gun that broke the laws of physics, but just like his heritage, nobody has been able to prove it. But if you want to see all of Monster Garage, you're going to have to pay for it. The show is split between individual episodes on Amazon Prime and the entire 5th season on Discovery Plus. At this point, you might be better off buying or renting a Monster Garage DVD box set and getting Discovery Plus to catch those last few episodes. Discovery Plus also has a lot of other shows we talk about on this channel. We're not sponsored, just fans. Today, Jesse James still operates Firearms Unlimited and manages the IP for West Coast Choppers. He also had another string of short-lived marriages, including a spotty relationship with Kat Von D and married drag racer Alexis DeJoria in 2013. In 2020, they announced the divorce. Jesse G. James is currently married to Bonnie Rotten, another name that sounds straight out of a Western. Jesse James from Monster Garage might not be a famous outlaw or a football player, but he's still a legend. He also has the same torrid life that most would associate with a name. But what's the weirdest coincidental name that you've ever heard? Have you ever met someone whose name fit their job so well that you wonder if they ever considered other occupations? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that bell. As the announcer on Monster Garage would say, the next awesome video is just around the bend.